My new novel, Tsukishi dans ses entrailles, is a novel of contemporary America. The story is set in Pennsylvania, where I grew up, and it concerns the fate of a small village that has had a very difficult history. This is a region that was once a region of coal miners, and in the past 30 years has come on some very hard times. At the beginning of the novel, the people of this town are offered the chance to lease their mineral rights for gas drilling. Now, this is a very controversial issue in the United States and in many other places. It is gas drilling by hydraulic fracturing. So there is a real danger to the environment that comes from this type of drilling. I did not write this book because I was obsessed with gas drilling. That was not the reason. I wrote it because I'm interested in the people of this region. This is really a book about families and marriages and an entire community that is transformed by this single decision to drill for gas. It is very much a contemporary question in the United States. This is a novel about social class, which was very important in the American election in 2016. So I'm writing about characters who many of them would have voted for Donald Trump. And so this is a novel that sheds some light on the question of how Donald Trump came to power in the United States. It's all in this novel. It took me 5 years to write and research this novel, in part because I had to learn quite a lot about the science of gas drilling. I am not a scientist. I knew nothing when I started to write. So there was a very long learning curve to get all the details right. As I wrote the novel, I came to understand that the story was much larger than this question of gas drilling. It has to do with our relationship to energy and the environment. It's not a new question. Most people don't know this, most Americans don't know, that the first oil well in the world was drilled in Pennsylvania. After that, we had an entire century of coal mining. We had strip mining. So these questions arise again and again. How do we produce energy without destroying the planet?